it's always exciting to find a lamp that is fulfilling the needs that I was looking for all those years ago. Well, Dedo lights have been the forerunners in development in terms of the quality of light that's produced and the quality of manufacturing, in that they're beautifully made.
I think we bought our first set of Dedo lights as a unit probably late 80s, early 90s. I can't remember the exact date. I mean, it was a set of four 100s, classic 100s. And it was just like, God, lads, we've got a light, we can focus, we can, you know, we can lock it in position. And you gradually get used to them. And those two, the 100 and the 150, really have been a workhorse now for us on model shoots, you know, for over 20 years.
Initially, the innovation of Dedo light was peerless, really. I just thought, what a wonderful... It was designed from the ground up. It wasn't just another version of a Fresnel lamp. It was actually designed as, okay, what's wrong at the moment with lamps, you know? And it was all so old. These things came along and they just started fresh, new, from the ground up, as I say. It's a great lamp. This new range continues.
It's not just a case of a big paint roller. It's a beautiful, fine bristle brush that you've actually painted gently exactly where you want the paint light to go. And these tools allow you to do that.
So when the Dedo came along, it was kind of like a game changer then. You know, for certain situations where you needed small, precise lighting. But nowadays, it's even more of a game changer, because nowadays, whereas before I'd have a set of Dedos for pack shots, you know, you have a pack shot immediately, every gaffer in the country knows this, pack shot Dedo. But now I'm looking at Dedos for serving way, far wider multitude of purposes.
So from the very start, it was all about one little lamp that you had with you, and then you build up the second one, the third one comes along, and fitting so many straightforward situations of interviews, pack shots, that sort of thing, where a nice little point source of really clean light is absolutely perfect and just brings the whole thing alive.
They are very so practical. That's it. So it corresponds to the way we live. We need to go fast.
They're beautiful lights, and they're small and they're compact, and they do the jobs that, you know, that much bigger lights did.
Really, the lights that get the most work are my Dedos, my little 150-watt, you know, light heads about this big, and they're incredibly versatile.
When we were doing a job recently, we actually had the Dedos constantly wired up just on long XLRs, just so that we could just quickly walk them in.
They are honestly the cleanest light out there, and as a photographer, it was really important for me.
I was surprised to see how powerful it was. The reason I was interested in it was because of its spot flood range, which is, I believe, 20 to 1. So you do get more range than any other light that I know of.
What got me initially was just the fact that you could dim them, just the fact that there was a built-in dimmer, and that made such a difference. And then I understood what the focusing ability was about.
The focusing principle of the original light is still very, very special about the Dedo light. I mean, there's no other light that quite has integrated that focusing, that the projection system that the Dedo light has, and none as good. I mean, if you are looking for a small unit that can focus like that, there is no better light.
up on the rail there, you see some of the most fantastic little tools on this planet. Very insignificant looking little lamp, but once you get to know it, they just are one of the finest lighting tools in the industry of its size and shape. The Dedo light, the standard DLH4, comes in various sizes, shapes, or when I say sizes and shapes, some of them have got transformer on the bottom, some of them will dim through DMX or through dimmer boards. There's the little 200 watt daylight version there. All the adapters and projectors and things that come with it, wide angle adapters, and as you can see on the bench there, there's a million one little adaptions of the Dedo light, which make this tool incredibly versatile, but makes it also a very surgical tool in terms of what you can do with it, from gobos to the DPI, which is for putting a slit of light across the eyes and diffusing it so you get light in the eyes. Just a neat slit of light across the eyes without you actually noticing it, but it's still there and effective. All sorts of lenses for projecting images, as you can see on the back wall there. You've got gobos. There's actually three different projections there. One is the Kinoflow logo, one is the actual lamp, and the third one is the splash of light coming out the front of the lamp, which is another lamp over here, which is just part of the illusion that you create. The DP2 with the actual shutter blades in it, which give you that particular shape on the wall there. Versatile lamps, 24 volt, 150 watt. I just find it's the only downside of this lamp is that it's addictive. Everywhere you go, there is some reason for using one of these lamps, and I don't know what the world would do if we didn't have Dedo Weigert in it, who invented this tool, because it's just an exceptional surgical lighting tool that just doesn't exist anywhere else on the planet. And it's just an amazing tool, and I'd just like to say thank you, Dedo. You've brought some light into our lives.